currently the Noel intro.
Mercy. Like someone in here needs to hear this. like you feel like you're breaking in pieces, and God is just saying, hold on to me. I will hold you together. I am there to be the glue between each of those pieces. And right now in your heart, you're saying, no, there's no way. I have been broken in pieces so many times, and I know this time is for good. And God's saying, it's not for good. I am there to hold you together. So whoever you are, just hold on to God's promise that he wants to be with you, and that he wants to hold you together. He is your amazing grace. Just remember that.
Especially at that young age.
I am so very proud of these girls and all they have accomplished. Before we continue to honor them, we are going to see some up and coming young girls ministry members, club members. We are going to start with our youngest, which is, like I was saying, the boys do start in preschool with us, and then once they enter kindergarten, they move up to Royal Rangers. So I would like David, who actually has advanced to Royal Rangers, but he came to help his brother Aiden, and they're going to say the Rainbow Pledge.
Music backgrounds and stuff for us.
And then Rasa, who is probably doing her thing, she did all the awesome decorations here, and I'm sure that Jim looks just as fabulous. She is our queen of magic for sure. And then, let's see, and finally, our worship band group team, Carmelina, Trina, and Noelle. Did you know that all three of these girls also were honor stars? And Trina was an honor friend. I'm not sure, Carmen, did you go beyond the stars? I can't remember.
They didn't have anything past.
They didn't have that. Yeah, that's one of the things that we discovered too, but these girls, as you'll hear later, are the ones who were motivated to get Girls Only started. So, great job, ladies. Let's see. Oh, and Leah, which is right there. Leah actually was an honor star and an honor friend and an honor Girls Only and achieved the gold medal of honor, which is three of our girls will do tonight. And I have a story to share about Leah, but I'm going to save that for later. So, all right, Girls Only. There's a lot, like I said, invested in Girls Only. Not only do they build on each other as you move up, but just for their club, it's a 4-year commitment. So when they came to me as friends, graduates, and said, we want to do this club, they knew that for the next 4 years, that was going to be the big part of their life. So during those 4 years, they need to complete 5 units a year. Each one takes about 6 weeks to complete. So what is that, 30 weeks? What else did they do? Oh, they had to memorize the verses in each unit and the central truth. They have journals that they keep up in. They look up scripture and write thoughts to and stuff. And they do projects. And then they need to read the entire Bible, memorize the statement of faith, which they'll be sharing with us tonight, and finally pass the Girls Only Review, which is a test over all their scriptures and central truths, which they all passed the first time, and I believe two of them got complete hundreds. So there you go. These guys are really, really high achievers. They actually did it in 3.5 years because last year we had an issue trying to find a leader, so we only had a park leader during the year. So this year was a catch up and cram year, and Leah was the lady for the job for sure. So we're gonna get ready. You guys ready up there? You wanna come down? All right, so now, please join me as we quietly welcome our Girls Only graduates. There will be a video showing their journey while the candles are being lit.
I was blind, now I'm seeing in color. I was dead, now I'm living forever. I had failed, but you were my redeemer. I've been blessed beyond all measure. I was lost, now I'm found by the Father. I've been changed from a ruin to treasure. I've been given a hope and a future. I've been blessed beyond all measure. I am counting every blessing, counting every blessing, letting go and trusting when I cannot see. I am counting every blessing, counting every blessing, surely every season you are good to me. it to me. For your goodness, I will ever praise you.
Fire for Jesus. better understanding and opportunity to continue her journey of holy living boldly for Him. There are a few people she would like to thank for helping her reach this monumental achievement tonight. She would like to thank her parents, especially her mom, for always pushing her to get past her procrastinating spirit and get her work done. She would also like to thank Justine, Trina, Leah, and many others who came before her. They have been great inspirations to her during this journey. It is very encouraging to see women living their lives for Christ, especially ones that came out of girls' ministries. Her teachers, Mrs. Carey, Mrs. Linda, and Miss Leah, have also been great inspirations, and she is so thankful for them and the time they set aside in their busy schedules to feed and teach them about God's truth, shown in the Bible and their own lives. Finally, she would like to thank the girls that have also gone on this journey with her, Heather, Jasmine, and Sophia. There were rocky patches at times, but she will always cherish the memories they made together. Thank you for sticking with her to the very end of this journey. God bless you all. This is Heather Lopez. She has been in girls' ministry since she was 2. And has honored in Daisies, Prim, Stars, Friends, and now Girls Only. Her favorite Bible verse in Girls Only is Isaiah 40, 30, and 31 from the unit Managing Stress. It reads, "Even youths grow tired and weary, and young men stumble and fall. But those who hope in the Lord will renew their strength. They will soar on wings like eagles. They will run and not grow weary. They will walk and not be faint." She likes this verse because amid all the stress and bustle of life, it's important to remember that our hope and strength is found in God. The thing that Heather has enjoyed most about her journey in Girls Only and Girls Ministries has been the mentors she had and the friendships she built. The memories she has with these people will stay with her forever. Out of all the things she has learned in girls' ministries, what she will carry with her through life is the importance of being part of a community of Christ followers, where she can grow and help others grow as well. There are a few people she would like to thank for helping her reach this achievement tonight. Her mom and dad for teaching and supporting her, Mrs. Julie for being a kind and hardworking coordinator, Mrs. Carey, Mrs. Linda, and Leah for being excellent teachers, Autumn for being the best sister that she could ever have, and Jasmine, Sophia, and Kara for their love and for being her closest friends for this entire journey. Thank you all. This is Jasmine Kwan. She has been in girls' ministry since age 11, honoring in the club Stars. Her favorite Bible verse in Girls Only is from the unit College and Career, and it says, "Trust in the Lord with all your heart, and lean not on your own understanding. In all your ways submit to Him, and He will make your path straight." Proverbs 3, 5, and 6. The reason she likes this Bible verse is because it assures her that as long as she puts her complete trust in God and obeys Him, instead of relying on her own abilities, her future will be taken care of. Two things she liked most about her journey in girls' ministries were meeting good friends and that have encouraged her to walk with God and having good teachers who have pushed her to go deeper into her faith. Out of all the things she has learned in girls' ministries, friendship is what she will carry with her through life, because having the right support system can make all the difference, no matter what life can throw at you. There are a few people she would like to thank for helping her reach this achievement tonight. She would like to thank her parents for always supporting her and pushing her to be the best that she can be. She would also like to thank Heather, Kara, and Sophia for accepting her into their group and always making class interesting. And lastly, her girls' ministry leaders, Miss Norma, Mrs. Winnie, Mrs. Rhonda, Miss Julie, Mrs. Carey, Mrs. Linda, and Leah, for always being amazing examples of what true followers of Christ are She would not be here without their guidance and instruction. This is Sophia Roth. She has been in girls' ministry since the age of 5, honoring in all of the clubs from Daisies to Girls Only. The verse that stands out to her the most from Girls Only is from the Will of God unit. The verse is found in Colossians 1, 9 and 10, and it says, "Since the day we heard about you, we have not stopped praying for you. We continually ask God to fill you with the knowledge of his will through all the wisdom and understanding that the Spirit gives, so that you may live a life worthy of the Lord and please him in every way, bearing fruit in every good work, growing in the knowledge of God." This scripture gives Sophia the strength, courage, and drive to live out her life the way God wants her to live, according to his will. It tells her that God will fill her with the knowledge of his will through all the wisdom and understanding that the Spirit gives, if she continually prays and asks him to do so. This verse also says that if she does this, she will live a life worthy of the Lord and pleasing to him in every way. This has given Sophia the ability to continually want to grow in her knowledge of Jesus Christ and to strive to live out his will and the plans he has for her. The thing that Sophia liked most about her journey in girls' ministries has been how it has immensely impacted her walk with Christ and has also allowed her to grow closer to her fellow girls-only graduates. Without the influence of all the amazing girls' ministry leaders and her friends, she would not be the person she is today. Girls' Ministries has taught her to ask questions and discuss topics until she fully understands them and can use them to grow in her relationship with Christ and ultimately for God's glory. Out of all the things she has learned in Girls' Ministries, determination is what she will carry with her through life. This is something that was instilled in her as a result of coming to class every week and doing her Bible reading and book work. Much of this was taught to her by the incredible girls' ministry leaders we have at this church. There are a few people Sophia would like to thank for helping her reach this achievement tonight. First of all, she would like to thank Miss Julie for being her girls' ministry's coordinator, something which she has done for many years, and for being her first teacher in the girls' ministry's program. She has dedicated so much effort, time, and love to this program and deserves much more credit than she gets. She would also like to thank all the other girls' ministries leaders that have been her mentors and teachers as she has gone through the program. Mrs. Rhonda, Mrs. Norma, Mrs. Carrie, her mom, and Leah. She wants to thank you all so much for the time and effort you have given to teaching her and teaching all the amazing young ladies in this program. We all greatly appreciate your dedication in leading us. Finally, Sophia would like to thank her wonderful friends, Heather, Kara, and Jasmine, for their friendship, encouragement, and support, and to her family for always supporting her through this girls' ministry's journey.
At this time, the sisters of our graduates will join them. Adam, Justine, and Noelle have been honored as stars in the girls' ministries program, and Emily is currently in the Stars Club. Go ahead and please come up. Graduates, as an honor star, you are reminded with your crown that you are a child of the King of Kings and Lord of Lords. As an honor friend, you received a ring signifying your commitment to follow Jesus and keep yourself pure. Now, as a girls-only graduate, you will receive a necklace that will serve as a reminder that you've committed to trust in the Lord with all your heart and lean not on your own understanding. In all your ways, acknowledge him, and he will make your path straight. Sisters, please put the necklace of commitment on your graduates. Thank you. Because of these added accomplishments, they'll receive the Gold Medal of Honor. The recipients of the Gold Medal of Honor are Kara Phillips, Heather Lopez, and Sophia Roth. Great job, you guys. Program help to guide you throughout your life.
Every day, every way, I will boldly live for God.
I now charge you to uphold the truths you have learned and to be a witness for Christ with everyone around you. May you also be reminded that no temptation is worth compromising your relationship with Jesus Christ, and remember your girls only pledge.
I pledge to reflect God in every part of my life. Spiritual, social, emotional, and physical, and stand firm in my commitment to Him both now and in the future.
And for the family and friends that are here tonight, I encourage you, when possible, to continue to admonish and teach them with all wisdom so that they may become more mature in Christ. Ladies and gentlemen, it is my great pleasure and excitement to introduce Orange County First Assembly's first ever Girls Only graduate.
Virgin birth, in his sinless life, in his miracles, in his vicarious and atoning death, in his bodily resurrection, and his ascension to the right hand of the Father, and in his personal future return to this earth in power and glory to rule 1,000 years.
We believe in the blessed hope, the rapture of the church at Christ's coming.
We believe the only means of being cleansed from sin is through repentance and faith in the precious blood of Christ.
We believe regeneration by the Holy Spirit is absolutely essential for personal salvation.
We believe in water baptism by immersion.
We believe the redemptive work of Christ on the cross provides healing of the human body in answer to believing prayer.
We believe the baptism of the Holy Spirit, according to Acts 2:4, is given to believers who ask for it.
We believe in the sanctifying power of the Holy Spirit, by whose indwelling the Christian is enabled to live a healthy, holy life.
We believe in the resurrection of both the saved and the lost, the one to everlasting life and the other to everlasting damnation. To serve him and to boldly proclaim him to others.
And then he didn't wait for opportunity to fall in his lap. He actually went out and did it. In fact, we were packing the car one time, and I said to my husband, "Where's my dad?" And he goes, "Oh, he's witnessing to the bikers over there." That is my dad. And you know, there are people who we know who give up everything to go and serve God in foreign countries. They leave the comforts of America and all the flushing toilets and the running water, and they go to places in the jungle or wherever where there's persecution, thinking that they may not even come back. They don't get to spend Christmas with their families, and they don't get to have all of the nice things around them that we have. People give their lives. They're willing to get burned at the stake. They're willing to be beaten or go to jail. What is it that causes these people to have such big boldness for God? And I think it is His Holy Spirit. There's a passage I want to read to you. It's very similar. In fact, I almost used this passage, the one that Sophie chose from Colossians. But I've used a very similar one in Ephesians. It's chapter 3, verses 14 through 21. And Paul is saying this. Now, Paul is writing this from jail. I imagine that it wasn't like jails we have today where there's TV and three meals a day and exercise time. It's probably cold and dark, and he's maybe lucky if a mouse crawls in there and he gets to bang on the head and eat it or something. I don't know. They're very bad jails over there. And he is suffering for the Lord. And yet he writes one of the most powerful prayers in the entire Bible. And I just think there is so much meat in here. It is so important. And this is where boldness comes from. He starts off by saying this in verse 14, "For this reason I kneel before the Father." And when he says "for this reason," he's talking about stuff that already happened. He's trying to encourage people to not be discouraged by the suffering that they see him going through or that they might go through. "From whom every family in heaven and on earth derives its name. I pray that out of his glorious riches," and I'm going to stop right there, out of God's glorious riches. Now, we know God has everything, every power, every good thing is His. It all comes from Him. And God chooses to come out of His glorious riches and bless us and gift us with things. He says, "I pray that out of His glorious riches, He may strengthen you with the power through His Holy Spirit in your inner being." Now, this is very important because when some of you, two of you actually, chose the verse from Isaiah about youths growing weary. And here you have God promising to strengthen your inner being, that part of you that gets discouraged and tired and weary and just like, "Oh, I just want to stop right now," or "I want to give up." God Himself dwells in you to strengthen that inner being with power so that Christ may dwell in your heart through faith. And it is by faith that this all happens. Some people know a lot about God. Some people even go to church and hear good messages and maybe read their Bible once in a while, but they haven't allowed faith to develop to know Him in a way that it actually changes them from the inside out. This is all known by faith. "And I pray that you, being rooted and established in love." When he says rooted and established, I think of two things. I think one, a tree, right? The roots. They go deep down in the soil. You have this big, huge tree. I was just at Yellowstone. Some of those trees are massive. Their roots go so far down in the soil, and they're not huge, and they're pulling up all of the nutrients that that tree needs to grow. And the soil that we are to be rooted in is the love of Christ. We go down deep, and we pull from that, and it gives us what we need to live in the way He wants us to. And established is like a building with a foundation. Our foundation is love. and you are a building that is immovable. You are just firm and unwavering in your belief. And in it too, that foundation is of love. He says that you may have power together with all the Lord's holy people. And this is amazing, to grasp how wide and long and high and deep is the love of Christ. And if you think of our God and our Christ, who is infinite, meaning there's no possible way to even measure. I think that's why Paul said it like this, because you can go as wide as you can and never come to an end. You can go high, you can go deep, you can do all of these things and never come to an end of the infinite love of God. And to know this love that surpasses knowledge. And that right there is pretty interesting. When you look at that, he's telling you he wants you to know something that surpasses knowledge. It sounds like, wait, what is he talking about? You know, I was thinking, even as humans, I can know someone and love them, like I love all of you. But if I were to hang out with you more and spend more time with you, and maybe 10, 20 years from now, maybe I'll know you even more. I keep going because there's more to know about you, and God is infinite, so we can keep knowing him more and more. You can know that love and continue to know it more and more. But I think here, this passage, when it says that it surpasses knowledge, he's talking about a love that can only be known through faith. This isn't human knowledge. This is part of the mystery of God, and Paul hints at that earlier in this chapter. He's talking about something that can only be known as your faith grows. This surpasses knowledge. Anything that you can learn with your human understanding, it goes way beyond that. And he says that you may be filled to the measure of all the fullness of God. And he didn't just say, I want you to be filled with God. He said, filled to the measure of all the fullness of God. So when you hear that, how much of God is not available to you? None, right? You can't be any more full than all the fullness of God. And this is what Paul is praying for people. You know, the Bible has so many promises, just like this. This prayer that he prayed under the inspiration of the Holy Spirit, if you look at it and you let it sink in and you, by bold faith, accept it to be true, then you will grow and you will understand and you will go farther than you ever dreamed possible. Because of this, God is a limitless God. Every single promise he makes is available to you. He says he wants you to be holy. He says he wants you to be bold. He says he wants you to live a life that fully pleases him. He wants you to take every thought captive. He wants you to love your enemy. He wants you to love everybody. He wants you to be bold and proclaim his word and to make disciples of all people. He gives you all kinds of promises. He says everything that you need for life and for godliness is available to you. And then this last verse in verse 20, it says, now to him who is able to do immeasurably more than all we ask or imagine, according to his power that is at work within us, to him be the glory in the church and in Christ Jesus throughout generations, forever and ever. Amen. Now, some versions translate this, he's able to do exceedingly abundantly more. Not just he's able to do exceedingly more or abundantly more, but he puts the two together, like abundantly, like exceeding abundantly is huge, more than you can ask or imagine. If you let yourself imagine what your life would look like if you walked every day in all the fullness of God, then above that, exceedingly abundantly above that,
is what God desires to do in you. God created you to be His workmanship, and He desires you to follow Him and to fulfill His will. He gives you everything you need to do that. So what does it look like when you go off to college, or you go back to school, or you're around people, and you are going to live boldly for God? Sometimes that means you have to look for opportunities to share what He's done in your life. Or maybe other people are going and doing something that doesn't honor God, and you have to say, no, I'm not going to do it. And it takes boldness to do that. It might be that He calls you to another country and He says, I want you to give up everything and go to this country and tell people that you don't know about Me. Give it all up for Me. Whatever He asks of you to do, and I don't know what that is. All of you girls will figure that out as you walk with Him. But whatever He asks you to do, He gives you everything that you need to accomplish that. That is how much God loves you. That is how much He wants to use you. And He is a limitless God. So don't put limits on Him. Let your faith rise to the challenge. Fulfill that girls only motto that says, every day, in every way, I will live boldly for Christ. So I am going to close in prayer. But before I do that, I kept pausing as I read that verse, that section. I'm going to read that as part of my beginning prayer to you, because this is what I long for you. I think if you could wrap your minds around the greatness of God and really look at these scriptures, believe them, and know they are for you, and that there is nothing in God's will that is impossible for you to do. Nothing. He gives you everything you need. So you shine for Him, regardless of the difficult situations or the things you might come up against. You always make sure that whatever you're doing, you are boldly living for Him. Be that light. Let's pray. I pray that out of His glorious riches, He may strengthen you with power through His Spirit in your inner being, so that Christ may dwell in your hearts through faith. And I pray that you, being rooted and established in love, may have power together with all the Lord's holy people to grasp how wide and how long and high and deep is the love of Christ, and to know this love that surpasses knowledge, that you may be filled to the measure of all the fullness of God. Now to Him who is able to do immeasurably more than all we ask or imagine, according to His power that is at work within us, to Him be the glory in the church and in Christ Jesus throughout all generations, forever and ever. God, I ask that you would put your hand on each one of these girls right here. Lord, I pray that you would establish this word firmly in their hearts. God, I ask that you would be with them every day, every step along the way, that you would guide them to your truth, guide them to your Spirit. God, I pray that every temptation, you would show them a way of escape. Lord, I pray that you would help them know the power and the victory that is available in you. That very same power that raised Jesus Christ from the dead is alive in us. That same Spirit, God, you have given us everything we need to accomplish your will. So, Father, I ask for these girls. I pray that you would help them to seize opportunities to share this love that they have in their hearts for you. God, that they would share that with other people, and that you would use them in great and mighty ways, and that there will be many people that go into an eternal glory with you because of these four lives right here, God. I ask that you would do everything you want to in their lives. Accomplish your perfect will in their lives, God. To you be the glory. You get all the credit, God, because you are worthy. You deserve to have our lives. You deserve to have our service. So, God, I pray that you would anoint them by the power of your Holy Spirit, and you would remove any doubts or any discouragement from their lives, God, but you would let them serve you with whole hearts, single minds, boldly proclaiming the love of God because they know you and they know how faithful and good you are. I ask these things in Jesus' name. Amen.
Since some of these girls were maybe 5 years old, if you are one of their teachers at any level, please stand. I heard all kinds of names mentioned, not just the last 4 years, but since 5 years old, walking along, being a part of that. Can we just thank all of these awesome teachers for going on their journey with these wonderful kids? And this truly, you're the leader of this band right here. 15 years, we're going to celebrate that next Sunday. We'll talk more about it next Sunday, but thank you for doing that. Please stand, and I just trust that you can stay for the reception. It's over at the Family Life Center. Everybody's welcome, of course, to stay. But I heard one of my favorite words mentioned over and over again tonight, boldly. I love that word, boldly. I love to boldly go. It's not just a Star, is that Trek or Star Wars or Star something? But it's the Lord fills us with the Holy Spirit and we need to go. So I love going to be with people. So if you take your hands like this, and let's pray a prayer of benediction that, Lord, here wherever you send me this week, I'm going to be ready for you to use my life, okay? So Lord, thank you for parents, for leaders, for friends that have come out tonight on this Sunday night. What a blessing to see these four ladies for how you have helped them to grow, Lord, through this program. And what incredible women they are. Beautiful and smart, talented, but they love you. And so now we pray a blessing on them. Keep it going, Lord. We pray a blessing on these teachers and these parents. Thank you for them. And now we would ask, Lord, that all of us would boldly go this week. Wherever you send us, we would be ready to share about you. You give us the opportunity, you open that door, we're going to be ready to share Jesus Christ with whoever we meet this week. And we ask this, Lord, in your name. Everyone said,
amen.
Amen. God bless you. All right, we'll see you down the next time. Thank you.